Some sleep.
I'm sorry. How can you sleep? The show is just getting started.
Well, the same way I sleep through all your shows.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And don't tell me you're going to do it one more time.
Well, I wasn't going to, but now that you mention it. One more time. And I took myself one step.
Julie Andrews. step into spring with her guests, Leslie Uggams, Leo Sayer, special guest Jim Henson's Muppets, and a special appearance by Alan King. Brought to you by Sears Roebuck and Company. Sears, where America shops. From the Atlantic to the Pacific, from border to border, wherever you live, the Sears family all over America is ready to serve you at a Sears store or through the catalog. Sears is where America shops. Ladies and gentlemen, Julie Andrews.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to One Step into Spring. And now I'm going to take my second step. No, I'm not. I forgot to say, may I? May I say, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and that it is so lovely to be here this evening. Spring is actually my favorite time of the year. It's a time for new beginnings and new friendships, like my guests this evening, Leslie Uggams and Leo Sayer, and of course my old friends, the Muppets.
Your ex-friends, the Muppets.
Oh, hi, Kermit. What do you mean?
Well, it isn't me, Julie, but the rest of them were pretty aggravated that they were cut from that opening number.
Oh.
I didn't mind. I don't wear tails. Mm-hmm. But the others, you know...
I can explain, you know, Kermit. Where are they?
They're rehearsing the comedy sketch in the hat shop set.
Oh, dear.
Oh, that sketch will be dear and funny.
And not in the show.
What?
Well, actually, see, the sketch has had to be cut.
Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy.
Well, I think perhaps we'd better go talk to them, hmm?
Julie, you're on your own.
Why?
Fear.
Uh-oh.
Hello,
everybody. I'm terribly sorry about the opening number.
You're sorry? I had a producer in the audience.
Oh. Oh, forget it, Julie. We've already gotten over it.
You've gotten over it. Frankly, dear, you needed me in that number.
What do you mean? I thought the kids did a lovely job.
Oh, the kids were fine. It's you that needed help, sweet thing.
Could you explain that?
You were flat.
Flat?
Now, Julie, this is no time to be testy-testy.
What is it time for, Ms. Piggy?
Ms. Andrews, it is time for moi to replace vous.
Pourquoi?
Oh, yeah, pig joke, get it? Pourquoi?
It's time for us to rehearse our hat sketch.
That's just what I came to talk to you about.
Oh.
Oh, I get it. I suppose you want to be in that, too?
No, that isn't it.
You're smart, dear. It's really not your kind of comedy.
Well, actually, it isn't yours either.
I beg your pardon.
Well, you see, I'm afraid the show was running kind of long and, oh, dear. We've had to cut the hat sketch.
What? Oh,
couldn't you have cut something else?
Well, what else could I have cut?
Well, like one of your songs. They do go on forever, dear.
I can't believe the hat sketch is out. I had so many bits. What about my chicken plucking routine?
Oh, Gonzo, it was a beautiful bit of physical business, but it wasn't going to make comedy history.
Oh, how am I going to break this to the chicken?
Come on, guys. Maybe Leo Sayer will let us work with him.
Oh, you think so?
I know so. We're all about the same size.
Watch it, lady.
Leo!
Yes, hey. Oh, hi, Rolf.
Hi there, Julie. How's it going?
Not so good.
Oh, don't mind them. Listen, I'd love to do a song with you.
You would? Mm-hmm. Oh, that's terrific.
Yeah, I know a good song. It's a little old-fashioned, but I like it. It goes like this.
Oh, now that's my kind of music.
Mm-hmm.
I'm old-fashioned. I love the moonlight. I love you
fancies. Our passing fancies.
But sighing sighs, holding hands, please my heart understands. But I don't mind it. That's how. I feel much better.
So do I. You know, it's nice to know there's someone squarer than me.
Spotted it, huh?
Well, Julie, I mean...
Yeah, it was inevitable, right? What do you think, Leo? Sneakers? Snoopy socks? Suspenders? Like it?
But it's not you, Julie. I mean, the wig.
You don't like the wig?
No.
Oh, I'm so glad you said that, Leo. This wig is absolutely killing me. Excuse me.
Whew. Oh, that's the real you, Julie. That's the real you. Oh, I'm so glad you've come back. Now we can sing our song together.
Ooh. I want you to know this is the first time that I have sung the harmony underneath the melody line.
Yeah? Yeah. Can I take that as a compliment?
You may. So usually I sing above the melody.
Oh.
Ready?
Yeah.
When I need you, I just close my eyes and I'm with you. And all that I so want to give, it's only a heartbeat away. When I need love, I hold out my hands and I touch love. I never knew there was so much love, keeping me warm night and day.
Miles of empty space in between us.
telephone can't take the place of your smile.
But you know I won't be traveling forever. It's cold out, but hold out and do like I do.
Tea at this hour of the night?
Well, actually, I could drink tea at any hour of the day or night, Leslie. And it's just really an excuse for us to chat.
Well, I love the cups.
Listen, I want to say that along with millions of other people, I thought you were sensational in Roots.
Oh, thank you.
What I thought was important about Roots, you told me earlier this week that you'd had so many letters from children, and that surprised me.
They were fascinated by Roots. And
but, I mean, what were the letters about? What did they say?
Talking about knowing more about their background, even getting closer to their families, because they kind of looked at Mom and Dad and Grandma and Grandpa in a different kind of light.
Yeah.
And it's wonderful to give children a sense of that, especially since you have little ones and I have little ones.
Well, we've both adopted babies.
Right.
You've got two beautiful children, and I do too. And I suppose even though they do come from different backgrounds, hopefully, if we give them enough love and a sense of continuity in their lives, they'll turn out all right. I do hope so.
I think so. In fact, I think that's the greatest gift that we can give to our children, is that love and a sense of themselves, so you know they're going to be all right when they go into the adult world. You don't have to worry about them.
Is it underneath the willow tree that I've been dreaming of? I believe the children are the future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. Need someone to look up to. I never found anyone to fulfill that need. A lonely place to be. So I learned to depend on me. inside of me. The greatest love in the world is easy to achieve. Learn to love yourself is the greatest.
You know, Leslie, a lot of people don't know it, but we really do have a lot in common.
We do? Were you in Roots, too?
No. You know what I mean. For instance, did you go to dance class?
Oh, yes, I went to dance class for my knees.
Uh-huh, me too. My mother sent me because I actually was bow-legged.
Oh, not need bow-legged. Wait a minute. I think we have a team here.
Did you like ballet class or dislike it? Or?
I absolutely hated ballet class because it was kind of frightening. There was this lady there with this cane all the time that used to beat time, and mm-hmm. if you missed anything, it was very painful.
Mm-hmm. I know.
That's frightening. How
I
about you?
I thought I was going to dislike it. In fact, I really wasn't too happy about it. My parents made me go. I think they felt it would be good for deportment and style and grace and all those awful words mm-hmm. that don't mean much when you're a child.
Right.
And I didn't like it too well to start with, but after I'd been there a little bit, it kind of grew on me, and the better I got, the more I began to enjoy it.
Mm.
Yes, everything was beautiful at the ballet. It was lovely at the ballet.
Daddy always thought that he married beneath him, that's what he said. When he proposed, he informed my mother he was probably her very last chance. Though she was 22, she married him. Life with my dad was never a picnic, more like a come-as-you-are. When I was 5, I remember my mother dug earrings out of the car. I knew that they weren't hers, but it wasn't something you'd want to discuss. He wasn't warm. Well, not to her. Not to us. But everything was beautiful at the ballet. Graceful men lift lovely girls in white. Yes, everything was beautiful at the ballet. I was happy at the ballet. Half a steep and very narrow stairway to the voice like a metronome. Off a steep and very narrow stairway. It wasn't paradise, it wasn't paradise. But it was home. Mother always said I'd be very attractive when I grew up. Different, she said, with a special something and a very, very personal flair. And though I was 8 or 9, I hated her. ballet. I used to dance around our living room with my arms up like this. And my fantasy was there was this Indian chief, and he would give a sweeping bow and say, "Julie, do you want to dance?" And I would curtsy, and I would say, "Daddy, I would love to dance." But it was clear when he posed that I was born to save their marriage. And when that's what he said, that's what she said, I used to dance around the living room. He wasn't born, not to her. He was an Indian chief, and he said, "Daddy, I would love to dance." Raise your arms, and someone's always there. Yes, everything was beautiful at the ballet, at the ballet, at the
started ballet?
About six.
I was six, too.
Really?
Yeah. Did you have to practice smiling in front of a mirror?
Mm-hmm. When I was singing, I did. Mm-hmm. Mostly for looking kind of attractive when I was singing.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Must always
yes.
look good.
And what about clothes?
Oh, my mother made me wear those cute little dresses with the big bow and the Mary Jane.
Yes, I had exactly the same thing.
Patent leather,
little ones. Short white socks.
Yes, that were always drooping down because my legs were about this much.
The thing I remember most about the early years was all that traveling and touring and boarding houses.
Yes, yes.
I'm sure you know what I mean.
Same thing, yeah. Right. But you seemed so perfect. I mean, it didn't affect you in any way.
Well, I just kind of shut the door.
Well, I didn't have to worry because I was always safe with Mitch Brown.
Were you as naive about men as I was?
Listen, I thought all you had to do with men was sing along. You know, was that naive? But anyway, I enjoyed doing it, and doing those sweet, nice songs.
Oh, mine were much worse.
What do you mean?
Well, they were nicer, you know, really.
Oh, ugh.
But I fantasized that deep down inside those very large Mary Janes, there was a real kind of gutsy lady just busting to get loose.
Oh, I know what you mean. And let me tell you, it is never too late, Julie.
You mean there's a chance for us yet?
We are gonna do some busting out. Come on, Jules, we're gonna paint the town. And all that jazz, we're gonna cut it loose and roll our stockings down. And all that jazz, start the car. I know a whoopee spot where the guys are cool and the band is hot.
You let other people make a fool of you. Why don't you do right?
other men do. Get out of here and get me some money.
Never know how much I love you. Never know how much I care.
When you put your arms around me, I get a fever that's so hard to bear.
You give me fever.
When you kiss me, fever. When you hold me tight, fever.
I'm also available for weddings, bar mitzvahs, meat market openings. And now, back to Laverne and Shirley.
Fever up through the night.
Daddy, won't you treat me right?
I'm tearing up a game of golf. I may make a play for the caddy, but when I do, I don't follow through, but my heart belongs to Daddy.
Now
door to the other guy. A good man is so hard to find. And all that jazz.
Below, up is where to grow, up with which below can compare with. Hurry, it's lovely up here. Life down the hole takes an awful toll, what with not a soul there to share with. Hurry, it's lovely up here. Wake up, bestir yourself, it's time that you disinter yourself. You've got a spot to fill, a pot to fill, and what a gift package of shower, sun and love you'll be met above everywhere with. Fondle and sniff by millions who drift by. Life here is rosy. If you're a posy, hurry, it's lovely.
Iceman, go up for my beauty bell, it's ringing.
The bright well shineth, tender untwineth, starry eye gloweth, for we know it that without thee, spring could never be.
Daffodil,
I can't stand still.
Gabby Fling,
lad and lass in tall, tall grass, gaily skippeth, nylon rippeth, zipper zippeth,
the ink of day, which is to say, the springtime cometh, hummingbird hummeth, sugar plum plummeth,
heart in humpty dummeth,
and to song.
I see, then come, rhododend, courage, little friend, everything will end, rhododandy. Hurry, it's lovely up here.
Spring is springing, can't help singing.
Geranium, it can't be fun, subterranean. On the exterior, it's cheerier. RSVP peonies pollinate the achoo, make the queen of bees hot as brandy. Come give at least a preview.
back to your beds.
Oh, you are my hero.
Oh, thank you. Listen, I was just looking for you.
Oh, yes?
Yeah, would you like to, you know, come over and sit down and we could have a quiet little chat or something?
Well, of course. Maybe even? Yeah. What's wrong?
Well, everything.
Oh, dear. I can see you're sort of blue.
No. I'm green.
Okay, what's the matter?
Well, just look at me. You notice anything?
No.
Exactly. No bonnet. And you know what no bonnet means, Julie?
Yes, it means you're naked from the head up.
You're a big help. Do you realize that not only was I not invited to the Easter parade, but I don't have anything to wear?
Uh-huh. I'm sorry, Kermit. I guess it just isn't easy being green.
Hey, you're not going to sing that song again, are you?
No, I'm not going to sing that song, but I am going to sing a song.
You are?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, good. That'll make me feel better.
In your Easter bonnet.
Bonnet? Or what bonnet?
With all the frills upon it.
What are you talking about?
You'll be the proudest fella in the Easter parade.
I told you I'm not going.
You'll be all in clover.
So I need more green.
And when they look you over,
they'll never notice.
You'll be the smartest fella in the Easter.
Well, who would I go with?
With me.
Oh, yeah?
On the avenue.
Gee, really?
Fifth Avenue.
Oh, maybe I could go.
Mm-hmm. The photographers will snap out.
Photographers? Uh-huh. You mean we get our picture in the paper and everything?
Everything.
We could become famous,
yes.
Even.
Yes. Oh, I could write a sonnet.
I mean, about my Easter bonnet,
mm-hmm.
Huh?
And of the frog I'm taking to the Easter parade. Dammit, this is for you.
Oh, wow. Oh, thank you, Julie.
Want me to open it up?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'll just get this knot under.
Mm-hmm.
Make me feel good, everything. you bring me up when I've been down. This only happens when you're around, and I can't go on this way.
Spring has been brought to you by Sears Roebuck and Company. From the Atlantic to the Pacific, the Sears family all over America is ready to serve you at a Sears store or through the catalog. Sears is where America shops.